to know how much I love you and care for you. I don't need to decide that you are the right perfect man for me because you brought out the best in me. Thank you for being so amazing in every way, for loving me so quickly. And for treating my mama and papa as your own. I can't wait to have more crazy nights with you, just like the first night that we spent together in, remember? I love you. You're everything. Jimmy.
Hearing that match each other's like our love matches. We always match. Also, they're sparkling with your cute little eyes. I love you, baby. They glitter like your smile. Glitters and brightens my world. Mahal na mahal kita, Alex.
Sure. the blessed joining together of Alex Angel and Kimiko in the holy matrimony. The ban and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation. And our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by His presence in the first miracle at Cana Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and His church, and the Holy Scripture commands it to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given each other in prosperity and adversity. And when it is God's will for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into advisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this union of Alex Angel and Kimiko now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not be lawfully wed, speak now or else forever hold your peace. Kung meron pang tumanggi, tumanggi na. At kung wala, habang buhay ng manahimik. So, dapat iti kayat na nga tumakder nga ibaga na tigilang kasala, tumayo na. Wala naman siguro. Kung wala, manatiling manahimik habang panahon. Alex Angel and Kimiko, let me charge you both to remember that your happiness, your future happiness, is to be found in mutual consideration, patience, kindness, and confidence, and also affection. Alex, it is your duty to love Kimiko as yourself. Provides tender leadership and protect her from any danger. Is that clear? Kimiko, it is your duty to love and treat Angel or Angel, Alex with respect, support him and create a healthy, happy home. It is the duty of both of you to find the greatest joy in the company of the other. Remember that in both interests and affection, you are to be one and undivided. Kimiko, will you have this man, Angel, or Alex to be your husband, to live together with him in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful unto him as long as you both shall live? Alex, will you have this woman, Kimiko, to be your wife, to live together with her in the covenant of marriage?
Yes, Father.
Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful unto her as long as you both shall live?
Yes, Father.
Let me just read a passage from the Bible in the book of Ephesians, chapter 5. Verses 22 up to the following verses, wives and husbands. Wives, submit your husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, Jesus Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord. Pagyamanan mi apot, kinaimbag mo. Pinagpapasalamat namin, O Diyos, ang iyong katapatan. Mula noon hanggang ngayon, ang pag-ibig mo'y nananatili. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And today, Father, it is our prayer. Bless this ceremony. Bless the couple. As they listen to your word, as they commit each other, Lord, it is my prayer. Be with them. Be with us. Your presence, Lord, is welcome in this place. Thank you, Father. We give you all the glory, the honor, and praises in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may now take your seats. Pwede na po kayong umupo. Sa bawat isang nandirito, let me remind you that this ceremony is a Christian ceremony. This is a Christian wedding. When we talk about Christian wedding, it's all about God, it's all about His Word, it's all about the Bible, which is the basis of our life, the basis of the ceremony, the basis of everyone sa kanyang buhay. Kaya sa hapong ito, let me give you this message, isang napakagandang mensahe first for the couple, syempre, because this couple needs the Word of God. This couple needs a foundation. Kailangan nila ng pundasyon sa kanilang pagsasama. Wala pa akong na-counsel na couple na nagsabi na pag kami nag-asawa, kami nagpakasal, ang gusto namin, 5 taon lang kami magkasama, mag-iiwalay. Wala pa akong na-meet na-counsel na ikinakasal o ikakasal na nagsabi merong hangganan ang kanilang pagsasama. Para bagang trabaho. Pagtrabaho kasi pag-uusapan, merong expiration. Pag 60 years old ka na dito sa Pilipinas o bago ka mag-60, kailangan dadaan ka doon sa retirement. Because you are already a senior citizen. Alam po ninyo mga magulang, mga kaibigan, ang pag-aasawa, especially Kimiko and Alex, ang pag-aasawa ay hindi parang trabaho na merong hangganan. Because the Bible told us na ang buhay mag-asawa ay hindi lamang 1 buwan, hindi lamang 5 taon, hindi lamang 20 taon. Ang pag-aasawa, they call this a lifetime commitment. Are you familiar with this, Alex? That a marriage life is a lifetime commitment. Na kung ayaw mo na, ibabalik mo na sa kanyang magulang. But let me remember this truth about this. In the Bible, in the Old Testament, napakagandang basis ng pagsasama at pag-aasawa ng lalaki at babae. When God created man in the book of Genesis chapter 2 verse 24, the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden. But before He took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden, God created man according to His likeness and image. Nilikha ng Diyos ang lalaki ayon sa kanyang wangis. But before He created man, He created everything, lahat ng bagay na kakailanganin ng tao. Everything that man needs, He created. And they call this, when God created all things around us, they call this creation ex nihilo in Latin word. And what does this mean? He created the animals, the plants, and everything around us from nothing to something. Mula sa wala, nagkaroon. Creatio ex nihilo. Coming only from the powerful word of God. He just said, let there be light, and there was light. Let the animals fill the earth. Let the fruit-bearing trees and everything. They call this creatio ex nihilo. But on the 6th day, the very important day for man, when God created man, kumuha ang Diyos ng lupa from dust. He formed it. At mula doon sa labok, pinorma niyang tao, and He breathed into His nostrils. And the Bible said, it became a living soul. Nagkaroon ng buhay, and he called him Adam. Tinawag ng Diyos na Adam yung first man He created. At yung lalaki, dito sa verse chapter 2, verse 24, the Lord God took the man, the Lord God took Adam and put him in the Garden of Eden. Napakagandang lugar, a very nice place that called Eden. Let me Let me tell you this, Alex. Eden means delightful spot. A perfect place for man. A perfect place for human. Yung salitang Eden ay napakaganda. Napakagandang lugar para sa tao. And he put the man in that place, in that garden of Eden. And remember this, Kimiko and Alex. Ang unang tao na nilalang ng Diyos ay si Adam. Ang unang kausap ng Diyos si Adam. That's why we have this saying, not only saying, we have this truth that man should be the head of the family. Ang husband dapat maging head of the family. By the way, the woman, mga kababaihan, it's natural and based on studies, ang mga babae talaga ay compared sa mga lalaki. Women are expressive. And there are men, most of the men are silent. Cannot express themselves. Introvert. But women, majority of them are extrovert. Kaya nga sa ating mga Pilipino, si tayong Pilipino niya. Pasensya na, nakalimutan ko na Ilocano. tayong mga Pilipino, 'di ba, mga kababaihan, may kasabihan tayo ngayon, maraming marites. Marites. Mahilig makipagkwentuhan. Hindi lang mahilig makipagkwentuhan kung minsan nasusobrahan yung kwento. And based on studies, sabi nga natin, based on studies, a woman, ang babae, ay kaya niyang bumigkas, bumitaw ng salita sa isang araw, aabot ng around 23 to 24,000 words a day. Ganyan katindi ang mga babae. They can utter words, 23 to 24,000 words a day. While men, in contrary, sa mga lalaki, tayo, mga kalalakihan, ay umaabot lang tayo ng around 12,000 words a day. Nagpapatunay lamang na ang kalalakihan compared sa mga babae ay aiksi ang buhay. Just try to observe around us. Sa paligid natin, kahit dun sa amin, sa lugar namin. This is my personal observation. Bakit kaya ang karaniwang naiiwan sa buhay nagiging balo, mga kababaihan? Bakit kaya mas mahaba ang buhay ng mga lalaki based on my personal experience and personal observation? Why? May dahilan ba? Bakit parang mas mahaba ang buhay ng mga babae? And based on my personal observation and assessment, may kaugnayan ito sa mga babaeng may outlet. Ano yung outlet nila? Mga babae kong galit. Sigaw. Hindi ko alam si Kimiko kung paano magalit. Kung paano niya express yung kanyang sarili pag may tampo o may galit. But usually, a woman, pag galit, sumisigaw. Nagdadadaldal. Kaya pagkatapos ng magdadaldal, na-relieve. Lumuwag ang kanyang puso. Huminahon. Eh ang lalaki, kaya maiksi ang buhay pag galit. Lalabas ng bahay, maghahanap ng kainuman nung pauwi na sagasaan. Maiksi ang buhay. Sa lang yun. Pangalawa, wala namang bisyo. Bakit napaaga ang buhay? Masama ang loob, nagkulong sa kwarto. Nung kakatukin na nila, walang sumasagot. Sinira nila ang pintuan. Pagtingin, naninikas na. Atake na pala. Bakit? Iba kasi ang babae. Ito, unawain mo yan, ha? Hindi yung magiging asawa. Ay, unawain mo. Kung hindi man siya extrovert, unawain mo. The same with you, Alex. If your wife is an extrovert, he can express anything with anger. You have to understand her personality because you have differences. You have a big differences. You know that? The women are talkative. While we, men, we can just keep it in our heart. Therefore, you have to understand each other. Alam mo ba, Kimiko, ba't nakaupo ka sa kaliwang panig ni Alex? Bakit ang babae pagkasalang katulad nito ay nandito sa kaliwang bahagi ng lalaki? You know why? During the ancient times, ang mga babae nandito sa left side ng mga lalaki. Dahil ang mga lalaki, hawak nila sa kanan yung kanilang sword to protect the wife, to protect the woman. Kaya Kimiko, may mag-iingat na sa'yo. Meron ang magtatanggol sa'yo. Sa anumang panganib, sa anumang problema, meron ka ng kasama. God's word. And God never told the woman about the tree. God put the tree of knowledge of good and evil at the middle of the garden. Ang sabi ng Diyos, you may eat any of the fruit of the tree except the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil at the middle of the garden. Ang pinagsabihan ng Diyos is the man, ang lalaki. Hindi alam ng babae. That's the reason why ang malalaki, responsibilidad natin na turuan ang ating mga asawa, kanya-kanyang asawa. Mga kalalakihan, dapat tayong nag-a-advise sa kanya-kanyang asawa. Kasi hindi sinabi ng Diyos kay Eve, kay Adam niya sinabi na merong fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil sa gitna ng halamanan na pinagbabawal ng Diyos. Why? Kasi pag kumain kayo nun, sabi ng Diyos kay Adam, mamamatay kayo. And that death speaks of separation from the presence of God. It's not about physical death. It's all about spiritual death. Mula sa isang magandang relasyon, mapuputol. Why? Because of disobedience to the Word of God. Disobedience to the law of God. Ang sabi ng Diyos, you may eat except the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Hindi alam ng babae. That's why ang babae nagkamali. And this is the shortcoming of Adam. Hindi niya nasabihan yung kanyang asawa. So, mga kalalakihan na katulad ko, responsibilidad po natin ang ating kanya-kanyang asawa. The male was the only one who got the Word of God to teach his wife the Word of God. She is looking for knowledge and direction. Women are looking for knowledge and direction from their husbands. It's not good for the man to be alone. Who's that man? It is not good for Alex to be alone. Why? Because the man with God's presence, the man working, the man can cultivate you, Kimiko. The man can protect you, Kimiko, and teach you the word. It's not good for him to be alone. Alex needs you. Kailangan ka ni Alex. At ikaw ang sagot ng Diyos. Panalangin ni Alex. And I also believe, Kimiko, si Alex ang sagot sa iyong panalangin. Si Alex ang sagot sa iyong panalangin. Siya ang binigay ng Diyos para sa iyo. Malinaw ba sa inyo ang aking sinasabi? Pwede ba kayong tumayo? Will you please stand? Alex and Kimiko.
Dear darling, if only you could look at yourself through my eyes. You look beautiful, breathtaking, and gorgeous. Your smile is the one thing I'll always strive for. Promise to stay with you in our darkest times, making you laugh so your smile and laughter light up the sparks to a better tomorrow. I vow to love you and treat you as la única hija that you are. I will do my best every day to be a better person for us. Our life together has only just begun, but I will celebrate our marriage every day and say it would never end. I love you.
Now here giving our vows together, and finally my dreams came true. When I first saw you, which is the funny part, bought something at the store where I work and asked me out. Sadly, I rejected your request, but to my surprise, you did not give up. You still pursued me, and that's when I realized that your intentions are pure and genuine. And as we continued with our relationship and get to know about you, it made our relationship more special. You took my breath away. No one else did but you, and you still do every single day. If I had to describe the perfect life partner, that would be you. Today, you become my husband, but you are also my best friend and my one true love. I will love, respect, and care for you through all the years of our lives. Through ups and downs, we will conquer this together. Thank you for loving me unconditionally. You have made me a better person for loving me for who I am. I will be proud to be called your wifey. I love you forever and ever.
Okay, may I have the ring, please? During the ancient times, we call the ring of the king the signet. Lahat ng bagay ng may marka ng singsing ng hari, it belongs to the king. Sa atin naman, pag nakasuot ang singsing na ito sa ating palasingsingan, it means you're already taken. May nagmamay-ari na sa'yo pag nakasuot ang singsing na ito sa palasingsingan. Not only signet ring, it also means ownership. Not only ownership, but it also mean ang singsing na ito nagpapakita ng authority. Habang nakasuot sa'yo ito, Kimiko, it means si Alex lang may authority sa'yo. May karapatan sa'yo. The same with you, Alex. While you are wearing this ring, it means Kimiko owns you. Dear Alex, wala nang iba. Pagmamay-ari ka, Kimiko, ni Alex, the same with you, Alex, you belong to. The same with the king, the signet ring speaks of ownership and authority. And with God's blessing, this ring will serve as a commitment to both of you. While you are wearing this ring, it reminds you about Kimiko. It reminds you that Kimiko loves you so much. The same with you, Kimiko. It reminds you that Alex loves you so much. Whatever may happen, you hold hands together in the name of God. For this ring, Alex, I want
you. Kimiko Amestan Tamura, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love. And with all I am, all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.
Alex Angel Rodriguez Rivera, I gave you this ring as a symbol of my love. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit and Jesus. Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, it's my prayer that you will bless this ring while it's on the ring finger of this man and woman, the couple, Alex and Kimiko. Dalangin ko dakilang Diyos, magsilbing selyo ng kanilang pagsasama ang singsing na ito. Dalangin ko dakilang Diyos na kanilang pagsasama ay mananatili in accordance to your word, in accordance to your will. Dalangin ko ang pundasyon po nila ang iyong makapangyarihan at mayamang salita sa pangalan ni Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. And this time, I want you to please kneel down. Candle speaks of life. It represents our lives. Pag sinindihan natin ang kandila, nag-uumpisa ang buhay, di po ba? May hangganan ang kandilang yan, namamatay yan. I-correct ko lang po ang marami sa paniniwalang katulad nito. At ang paniniwalang naniniwala sa ganito, sasabihin ko sa hindi totoo. Halimbawa sa kasal na katulad nito, kung sino daw yung namatay yung kandila niya, mauuna siya. Hindi po totoo yun. It is unbiblical. Because candles are just symbols. Symbols which means it reveals truth about life. Na ang buhay may pasimula at ang buhay may hangganan. And not only that, bakit nagkakaroon ng hangganan ang buhay sa panahon ng malakasang hangin? Pag may bagyo, yung kandila namamatay. Kimiko, may pagkakataon na may problema, manghihina. Mabigat na problema, pwede kang mawalan ng liwanag. Kindly blow your candle. May time manghina si Kimiko, but we are so thankful your husband is there to help you. As your husband, to light your candle. Give your strength. It's good that your husband is already there to help you, to guide you, and give you strength. There are times also, Alex, problems may come in your life. And those problems will resolve into passion, maybe your life will be lost. Kindly blow your candle. And during those times, weakness, problems, you are lucky. You are blessed. Why? Your wife is always there, waiting for you and want to give you strength. Your wife is already there, want to help you. Thank you. Yan po ang nagagawa ng mag-asawa, nagtutulungan. Ginagawa ng mag-asawa, hindi nag-iiwanan. Ginagawa ng mag-asawa, nagpapalakasan. Dahil may kanya-kanyang weakness, may kanya-kanya tayong kahinaan. But the good thing is that each couple understand each other. There are times sa buhay ng mag-asawa, parehong may problema. Both of you, kindly blow your candles. Pag nawalan sila ng ilaw, hirap ng buhay, hirap ng problema, hirap na kanilang pinagdadaanan. And it's good, they know God. They believe in God and they trust God that God will help them to survive in their problems. Ask the Lord to help you and ask God for strength. Kindly light your candle with God's power, with God's light. And Lord, salamat po sapagkat ang kandilang ito'y simbolo ng buhay. Most especially, Father, ang sabi mo, you are the light of the world. Thank you, Father, because there is no amount of darkness can dim the light of these little candles. We thank you, Lord. Dalangin ko, pagpalain mo ang buhay ni Alex at ni Kimiko. Sabi ng iyong salita, Panginoon, let your light shine before men that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. And today, I charge them into your hand, Lord. Ang buhay nilang mag-asawa, dalangin ko pagpalain. Ilayo sa mahigpit na problema, ilayo sa mabibigat na pagsubok, magkaroon sila ng buhay na pinagpala na nakapatuon ang pananampalataya sa iyong mga salita. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Mamahal sa iyo.
I think kapag kahirap magtrabaho para sa amin. Thank you kasi napalaki niyo ako ng mabuti. Thank you po.
My dearly beloved parents, brothers and sisters, friends, let me introduce to you the newlywed in the person of Mr. Alex Angel and Kimiko Rivera. Isa pa nga pong mas malakas na palakpak para sa bagong kasal. Kindly face each other, Kimiko and Alex. Alex, you may now kiss your bride. Pinapakilala ko pong muli ang mga bagong kasal na sina Ginoong at Ginang Alex Angel and Kimiko Rivera. Sila'y mag-asawa na sa pangalan ng ating Panginoon.
Thank you. to count 1, 2, 3. Let's throw your bouquet. Ready? Okay, ready na ba? Ready! 1, 2, 3, and go! Ay! Ayan naman, ayan, binigay sa maid of honor. Ayan talaga ikaw nang next, Madam Ronette. Thank you so much, ladies. Ayan, hindi ko alam yun ah. Okay. Going to use your teeth, okay? Your mouth, okay? Just go, okay? Go dance. Wow. Oh my God. Come on, Alex. You can do that. Oh my God. It's too early for the honeymoon. Yeah, he got it. He got it. How about a big, big round of applause? Yeah, the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3, and go. Ay, wala. What? Ay, higari talaga. Yan, best ma talaga. Congratulations! So ngayon, ikaw naman ang magsusuot sa ating bride-to-be. Ayan. Ayan, habang syempre sumasayaw din ng sexy dance. Okay, music please! Ay, Kim. No, isa pa, isang giling. Come on! Hanggang waist. A joke lang, a joke lang. Okay, palapakan naman natin sila. So hold on to hope, love. I searched high and low for you. For you. Each day gets closer. So hold.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kim Marcison. You may call me as Kim. Just a brief history. Alex and I just met just eight days ago. But anyway, it's just a short trip. But anyway, we were able to get along and had some fun. I saw how genuine and sincere he is for Kimi. And I really saw the chemistry they have, the both of them, and I felt that they were just made for each other, and I wish them an everlasting love, joy, and happiness. Finally, two souls become one, and two hearts beat as one. All the very best for your future, you two. Yes. Let's have a toast. Let's congratulate these two.
Okay.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Ronette, the maid of honor and the bride's best friend. Over the past 6 years, I've witnessed Kimi's prioritize everyone else's happiness. But today, we get to honor hers and finally found her one true love. You know, meeting Kimi is such a wonderful journey I've experienced while staying in Japan. Our bond and friendship, especially the craziest one, are the best. Our friendship stayed for over 6 years until now, being here witnessing her in her wedding day. I feel blessed to and thankful to have witnessed your wedding ceremony. My wish for the both of you is that you continue being the crazy, loving couple that you are, crazy for each other, always and forever. Congratulations to you both. Cheers.
Magandang hapon po sa ating lahat. Una sa lahat, nais kong ipaabot ang aking tauspusong sa ngalan ni Mayor, ang tauspusong pagbati sa inyo, Alex and Kimmy. Congratulations and best wishes. We are so happy to witness your wedding today. I'm just so sorry that your grandpa was unable to make it this day na makita ang iyong wedding. I know that your grandpa Pepito is watching over you from heaven, and I know that he will be very happy, and he is happy seeing you both settled as a couple. So I pray to the Lord that you will love each other forever and make Christ the center of your life. A wedding is not, or marriage is not, a bed of roses. There will be lots of challenges, but always remember how you love each other when you first met, and always think of your kids when you have kids, no? Don't ever let problems overcome you. Just pray and keep that love flaming, and always keep faith in the Lord. Whatever problems that you have, you'll lift it up to the Lord, and He will help you and guide you. So we wish you a good and happy marriage life, and build a strong Christian family. Congratulations again, and God bless you.
Yeah, thank you so much once again, Madam Mernabel Cioy.
Good afternoon po sa inyong lahat. Congratulations to both of you. Best wishes, and I pray to God that may you live happily ever after, and many kids. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. Inang. Okay, so it's time. Pakinggan po natin, of course, ang isa sa ninong natin. Ayan, si Ninong Edwin Tamura.
Good afternoon to everyone. Congratulations, Dimico and Alex. I hope you take happily forever.
Thank you so much, Nino. Palapanan po natin si Nino. Maraming salamat po.
So happy to meet you, Alex, and Chemical. And I wish you all the love and luck in the world. And I'm sure you will live for many, many years and be very, very happy. And that would make me very happy. That's it. Thank you.
Alex, Chemical, Sean, to both of you. And best wishes. With marriage. And happy life, and
sana mabigyan niyo ako ng apo. All my friends and relatives, thank you for coming for celebrate son-in-law or their marriage. Thank you.
Okay, yan. Very emotional si mother.
Thank you for coming, everyone. Thank you. I appreciate all of you. Thank you.